Thank you very much indeed, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome from me to this very special edition of Juke Box Jury. Let me immediately introduce you to the members of our panel. First, it's my pleasure to introduce you to a lady who's currently riding high on the charts with a song from the film Scandal, Dusty Springfield. Not just a record star, but now a film star too, from Genesis and from Buster, Phil Collins. Here's a young lady whose record in, I think it was 86, went to number one in the charts with Communards, Sarah Jane Morris. Now, Juke Box Jury was broadcast from 1959 to 1967. On the very first program was the person who, in fact, is here tonight, who was on the very last program. And I think I know the truth of the matter is that he was responsible for it being the last program. Ladies and gentlemen, Pete Murray. There may be many of you watching this programme who, in fact, have never heard of Juke Box Jury, who have never seen it. Let me tell you roughly what it's all about. When it was on all those years ago, it was on every Saturday night at the same time, and it was the only place that you could actually see and hear at the same time new releases on television.
The tropic sun grows cold till this young world grows old.
With my heart in my hand, with love and devotion, I'm at your command. Folks say you love another, but don't explain. If you need me, just call me, and I'll understand.
Our studio audience would listen attentively as they watched the artists before them. And when it came to actually judging the records, the jury would either vote the records a hit or a miss. If it was a hit, I'd ring a bell.
The voting is done. Yes, and a hit, we shall surely see it.
If it was a miss, I'd hoot a hooter.
Undoubtedly that it's a...
Now, this programme is going to play it just the same way. And if there's a hung jury, that means if two people say it's going to be a miss and two say it's going to be a hit, well, we have a second jury, just as we always did have all those years ago, sitting in the audience. We'll go to them perhaps later in the programme when we need them. That's the way we're going to play it, just the same as we did before. The only difference, really, I think, is as opposed to just hearing records, you will also see, because we're in 1989, pop videos as well. So let's hear the first record.
Cause a pretty face got the best of me. Suddenly, you came into my life and gave me meaning and pure delights. Now good looks I've learned to do with that. Cause now I know it's love that really counts. Beauty is only skin deep. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Said I know beauty is only skin deep. Oh, yeah. Speak your words warm and sincere. A pretty face you may not possess, but what I like is your tenderness. A pretty face may be some guy's taste, but I take loving in
Britain's foremost reggae group, Aswad, and Beauty's Only Skin Deep. Well, Pete, what do you think of that?
Well, I'm just sitting here. It feels like being in a time capsule. It seems unbelievable that it's, 22 years ago since we did this programme. Is that right, 22 years ago?
20.
Well, 1967, you said, isn't
it? Did I say 67?
You did, yes.
Oh, well, then you're right. Yes, he can count.
Well, you can see why he got the job, can't you? Well, no, what you asked me about the record, which I will be only too pleased to talk about. If we'd have played that in 1967, I think it would have been just as perhaps as successful as it's going to be today. I like it.
You do?
Yeah, I like it. Quite nice.
Sarah Jane Morris.
I love the group Aswad, and I think radio doesn't pick up enough on reggae. I think it's a very good version of, as Phil here pointed out, a cover of The Temptations.
Temptations, yes.
I was disgusted that I couldn't remember that one. But, I think it's very groovy.
Right, Phil Collins, what do you think?
I thought it was great. I, too, like Aswad, the nice guys. And it is sometimes when people do covers of Motown songs, they kind of don't do them justice.
It was The Temptations, wasn't it?
It was The Temptations, yeah. And we were talking about it earlier. You know, there is a enormous back catalogue of songs to be covered from any of the Motown artists.
Yes.
Yeah, and fantastic. And I think it's a great version of it. I think it's great.
What about you, Dusty?
Yeah, Phil's really said it all. It has a very slight different flavour, even though they're doing most of the same chords and very much the same feeling. It's just a little lighter. I think if you're going to do something and then do it well, and they certainly have, I really liked it very much.
Well, do you think it's going to be a hit or a miss for Aswad?
Do we all press it at the same time?
Yes, you all press it at the same time. Well, it doesn't really.
He electrocutes.
And they all say, all four of them, that it's going to be a... Very good. The first record on the programme is going to be a hit. We'll wait and see whether it really is as the weeks go by. Here's record number two. That's the first UK release of a Canadian group led by a young singer called Candy, Under Your Spell. Sarah Jane Morris.
Well, if I hadn't seen the video, I'd have sworn it was Madonna.
They call her the new Madonna. Ready for a new Madonna or not is another matter.
Old Madonna, what's that?
Well, it has... It's just like a copy of a Madonna record, so it has all the makings of being a hit, if that's anything to go by. She looks about 15, and as... Did you not think?
Yes, I did, yes.
Now, Phil, be careful.
And as most of the single-buying public are 12 and 13-year-olds, I think it's sort of probably got a great deal of charm.
So, Phil Collins, what do you think?
Well, she can come and sit on my lap any day.
Phil, for the benefit of the audience and for you, she is in fact over 16,
is
so she
really
can sit on your lap.
It's yes. Jolly good, sorry. And another lawsuit. I agree with Sarah that she's very Madonna-ish, you know. I think in America, these kind of records are more likely to be hits than maybe in this country.
Dusty?
It's funny. There's a lot of good music in Canada. I lived there for a while, and a lot of the bands there, they have a very hard time breaking out of that market. They have to be signed in Los Angeles or something. And it was very reminiscent of a lot of things, and I think it was very good of its kind. And if it gets on a major playlist, then indeed it's got all the right ingredients. I think it would... The promotion men really push it because it's a good record.
Pete Murray.
Well, I've only just got used to Madonna, let alone having... I think it's a very well-produced record. I think the girl's very good. I don't think there's anything particularly new about it. It's a question of how often it's played on the radio, I guess. Mm. But who am I to judge? I can't see too many people going out and buying it or rushing out to buy it. I think it's just a pleasant record.
Well, it comes the time now for you to press your buttons. Candy and Under Your Spell, hit or miss? And they say that it's not going to be a hit, it's going to be a... Oh, we shall watch that one. Sad, Dusty was the only one who actually voted it a hit, I think, on that one. So, off we go with record number 3. Featured in the film Tin Men, that was a good thing, by fine young cannibals headed there by Roland Gift. Phil Collins.
Very 60s, pretty obviously that. I mean, didn't have quite the spark of some of the sort of... I mean, if you're going to have the sort of 60s sound, maybe you just sort of have a couple more things that I like from the 60s. I suppose that's a very biased point of view. I think it'd be a hit, though, because I think they're very, very popular, and is very good, Roland. Good in Scandal as well, which is... Dusty's...
Sorry.
Use your hand in there,
I think it'd be... So, what do you think, Dusty?
Well, I'm terribly prejudiced because I have a terrible crush on Roland Gift. I think he's great. He wouldn't even have to sing. I just love his face. It's really, truly an interesting face. I can see it in fashion ads and everything. yep. It's a hit because of who they are. I see what they're going for, and, yeah, people will really buy this.
Do you think they will, Pete?
Yes, I do. I loved it from the word go, because I think the piano player is fantastic. I don't know who he is, but he's absolutely brilliant. And I think the riff at the beginning really appealed to me. And I think the fact that it's in a film, I think that's also very important. It's done very... films did pretty well for our two guests here. Like, Dusty's got a big smash from a film, Scandal, and, of course, Phil had the hit from Buster. So... I think films sell records if the film is popular enough. And
the film actually was made in 87. And I think
oh, well, that's
released.
All right. That's, you've got even now for 67 and 22 years. I knew it would happen to me at some time, rather. So the film's gone, has it?
I think so.
No, I didn't see the film, I'm sorry to say, but I like a record.
Sarah Jane.
Well, they're very popular at the moment, the Fine Young Cannibals, particularly because of Roland Gift and his film career. But I think it's very reminiscent of lots of 60s songs. I mean, I heard so many in there. But it does work, and I think it will be a hit.
Well, let's vote it then. Hit or a miss for The Good Thing by Fine Young Cannibals. And all four. Hit, they say, that will be. Good thing they did, because we have with us Roland Gift. Oh. It was worth coming, Dusty.
After him, that is.
Right. Thank you very much.
He is very
Dusty Springfield has actually got the vapors.
Yeah,
but she'll come back with us in a
moment. A glass of water in a couple of minutes.
Let's go on to the next record. Birdland and Hollow Heart. Dusty Springfield.
I feel like a boring old you-know-what, but it's just not my type of music. I think in the States it's called garage music, and there is a very real following for it, the headbangers, is that? And it's sort of, it's just a field of music that is just not particularly my taste. There's something about walking into this kind of music live, though, that just sort of blows you away. I mean, it's pure volume, and I think it's very, very hard to capture it on record. They come as close as anyone I've ever heard. But I'm the wrong person to ask. There's an enormous market for this, though.
Well, Pete Murray's an old headbanger, we know.
I've been banging my head for you. Have you got them backstage, by the way?
Well, do you really want to be told?
Well, no, it doesn't matter, but right. I assume that you're going to have one lot on. If they're not backstage, I'll tell you what I think of it. It's a load of crap. But, no, I can't. That's not very fair, but...
Don't sit on the fence.
No, it's not very fair, because it's just not gear for somebody like myself, and I really can't understand it. So, to those that like it, good luck to them, but I don't.
Sarah Jane.
Well, it's also not really my type of music. They're not really a singles band. You don't really hear this sort of music on the radio. It sells albums, and it has very strong followings live, as you said. Yeah. And the energy of it is incredible, I would imagine, at a live gig.
It's fantastic.
Yeah. But so I think we're all the wrong people to judge this. Yes.
No, you're not. Indeed, you're not. You are. You all have an opinion. Phil Collins, what's yours?
It's really up my street, David.
And, Yeah, man!
Yeah, baby.
The Sex Pistols, which was angry rock, you know, angry music, which I thought no one's really bettered that for me, because they were angry and they got it on record and it sounded great. And Johnny Lydon, I'll never forget. But, not that there's probably anything like that. I mean, I don't know. I don't think I sound like my dad, don't I? I don't know.
I've never heard your dad.
It's not particularly. Well, he's been dead since 1972.
Yes, so,
no, I don't think it's going to be a hit, though. I've got no chance of bitten in a hit.
All right, well, let's go for Hollow Heart.
Doesn't get played that.
Hollow Heart team and Birdland. Hit or a miss?
Sorry. Just doesn't get on the radio.
And they say, I'm afraid
it's
they
a shame.
Say it's going to be a.
Don't be there, please.
I think it's rather a shame that we've never had so far to go to our second jury in the audience. I think it'd be rather interesting, as we've had a miss for that, if we went to them and see whether they thought it was going to be a hit or a miss themselves. So, second jury, look at that, all three of them. All three say... Just shows you.
We're too old. We're too old.
Good night, everybody.
Yes. Got my stick, I'm leaving now.
All right, let's get on to record number 5.
Towards the night, for you and I,
couple of years ago, they were voted the best British group, 5-star, a family group, with every heartbeat. Sarah Jane.
Well, I've got a 15-year-old brother who, for the last couple of years, couldn't make up his mind which of the girls he was in love with. I think he's now just about grown out of them, so he might be very embarrassed about what I'm saying now. But I think it sounds like a hit. It's not my kind of music, but it's good dance music. And I think it's got the...
Don't forget there's only room in the charts for so many records to be used.
But there's nearly always a slot for 5-star. They're very popular.
Phil.
Yep. They dance just like I do. I like it. I think it's definitely... I think it could well be a hit because they are very popular. And it's the only thing like that we've got, you know, which is... you know, there are lots of music, lots of bands like that in the States, but over here,
yeah,
that's it, you know, 5-star, and they're good.
Do you agree,
they stand up with it all the American.
I agree with them all the way down. I mean, when you read some of the music papers, they enjoy sort of slagging them off because they're slick, but they're really good. I mean, I didn't know they were English for the longest time because the records sound very American, and the Americans are terribly good at that kind of record, so I'm fiercely proud of them for being British. I think they're absolutely wonderful.
Pete.
Yeah, I agree with Dusty. She says they're slick, and I'll go even further, and I think she probably means the same thing as I do, very professional. They are
it's
a very professional
same,
group. Yeah, that's right. Mm. They're a very professional group, and it's the type of record that if I went into a discotheque, which is highly unlikely, I would ask you to dance, David. There's no doubt about it at all. Particularly with that jacket. I love the jacket.
You do?
Yes.
You like it?
Yes, very, very smart.
It's very svelte.
It's the one, you know.
What?
This is the same one that I wore on the last programme.
What about that? And the underpants to match, too.
No. I have to tell you, Pete.
What?
The truth, I have to be honest, the jacket fits, but the trousers don't. So I have an odd pair of trousers on.
Oh, but never.
But nobody sees me standing up.
We haven't got any trousers on at all. Don't worry about it.
Right. Anyway, we've got to, with every heartbeat, 5-star. Is it a hit, jury, or is it a miss? And they say, undoubtedly, no question of that one, a hit. Good. Let's get on to the next one.
Is it love? Or is it? I'm just all right.
Zig Sputnik and Dancerama. So, Phil Collins.
I like that a lot. It was very different. I like the kind of approach to the rhythm, which is more my kind of thing, and I like it. So it could well be a hit.
Dusty.
I liked it, but I like the other one better. I can't remember. We went, success.
What success.
Yeah.
success. You got it.
They're so wonderfully vile. I mean...
And they're here tonight.
No, I mean, they do it purposely, and they do it very successfully, and the kind of thing, they're absolutely marvellous. This gets enough play to plays it to hit.
What do you think, Pete?
Well, I was watching the audience just now, and I think they've done remarkably well this evening, and I'd like to congratulate them. I think most of them have come here for songs of praise. Well, I mean, you'd think I was gone a bit if I said I liked it, wouldn't you, really? You'd be a bit... I mean, do you like it, David? Let me put him on the top. Do you like that, David?
Shall I say that I don't dislike it?
No, you don't. You always were a creep. No, it's not my scene, but I can see it being a hit.
Sarah Jane.
Well, they're a truly outrageous band. I've never bought a record of theirs, but I think this has got the elements of a hit once again. I think it's, once again, it's like if it gets the radio play. But that's the case for nearly any song. If it has the radio play, it'll be a hit.
So, Dance, Rarama, Zig Zig Sputnik, hit or a miss?
Minor.
And they say, hit. And they are here tonight. Oh! Tony, Martin, and Neil, at least.
Say, David, yes, I think you're overdressed.
Well, all I can say is, Pete, they weren't like that in our day.
Yeah.
Look, pretty close, but not quite. Right, let's see what happens with the next record. Orbison there, and she's a mystery to me. Is there any mystery to you, Dusty Springfield, about that?
Absolutely, no, I have nothing profound to say. I mean, it's obviously such a major hit.
Right. Do you agree with that? I'm going to go back the other way this way and go to Phil Collins next. Phil.
Yeah. Man, a few words. I thought it was great. I'm not a fan of Roy Orbison, but I thought that was really fantastic, actually.
Sarah Jane?
I think he's got a truly beautiful voice. And, I think it's going to be a big hit.
What do you think, Pete?
Well, his record's had a tremendous boost recently. He's had a lot of hits after he passed away, but I'm not as keen on this as some of the other records I've heard. I have to be honest about it. I don't think it'll be a hit.
Well, will you vote it, hit or a miss, for the late Roy Orbison? And they say, hit for that one. Now, Pete Murray, I wonder if you remember what you said about Roy Orbison way back in 1960.
No, I don't.
Yeah, I have. I can't use it. This is a record. I liked his previous record, Only the Lonely, which went, of course, to number one. I think he's still at number one. But I don't like this as a follow-up. But by virtue of the fact that it is a follow-up, it might well become it. What did you say about my hairstyle?
It's changed, isn't it?
Yeah, I can't do a thing with it. I did try. Believe me, I did try to get rid of it. I'm delighted to say I couldn't.
He's a very funny fellow. Yeah. Oh, God.
Pete, what recollections do you have of the old Jukebox Jury all those years ago?
Well, I remember the first Jukebox Jury we did, David, when we got into a lot of trouble when we finished up on the front page of the newspapers,
That's
if you
right.
remember. By what happens on today on television, it was totally innocuous. But I think I said, I don't know why you're being so rude to me, David, because I think you do a great job in the Leicester Square toilet. And you replied, mention my name and I'll get a good seat. But we've got a lot of trouble. That's pretty innocuous. Are you shocked? Yeah, shocked.
Do you think it had a great effect on the record buying public?
No, I think it had an effect on the record buying public, but like what we're saying here today, I don't think it means a light about what we say, because people make up their own minds. Yeah. They're not dictated by any so-called pundit, which is good. I'm glad they make up their own minds.
Sarah Jane, do you have any recollections at all of this programme?
Yes and no. I can remember it.
You remember
being
the repeats, don't you? She remembers the repeats.
I was very, very young.
Of course it was.
I was aware of it.
It was in those days in black and white. Jukebox Jury has never been out in colour before. And, of course, there was only one other programme that you could watch on the other side. Phil, did you watch Jukebox Jury?
Well, I too was very young, don't you? I did watch it, yeah. And I think what Peter was saying about critics, I mean, in the old days, and I'm talking about when the programme was on, I don't mean that, you know, when that programme was on, I think people probably did take much more of a, you know, yeah, belief in what people said than now. Where the music press, you know, they have very opinionated and very biased towards a certain area. And people basically, they know that the person's going to be biased writing the review or whatever, and they'll go and find out for themselves. I think that's more true nowadays than it was then. But I used to sit there every Saturday night and watch it.
Dusty Springfield, your records must have been on the programme from time to time.
Yes, I've blocked the verdict. I can't quite remember whether... I do remember, I think, with the Springfields, we were behind the screen.
Yes, you were.
I don't remember that verdict either, but I don't have any bad memories, so they must have said it was going to be a hit.
Did you enjoy doing the programmes in those
years?
Yes,
just as much as I did tonight. It's been fun.
Good. Yes. Thank you very much indeed. And just to put the record straight, a lot of people say to me, ah, that's the programme, Jukebox Jury, with that girl called I'll Give It Five. Well, of course, Janice Nichols was never on Jukebox Jury. She was on Thank Your Lucky Stars. My thanks to our panel on this special edition, Pete Murray, Sarah Jane Morris, Phil Collins, and Dusty Springfield. And my thanks to you for being with us. Thank you very much, and from Jukebox Jury, good night.